Good morning to everybody. Today we are going to discuss finite element method and finite element analysis, a brief fundamental concept oriented we are going to discuss. My name is M. Sivaramakrishnaya. I am working as assistant professor Sri Venkateswara College of Engineering and Technology, Autonomous. Now let's start. Now finite element method, what are the steps involved? Here we have three or four phases. The first phase is phase one. In phase one we have problem statement. Problem statement meant what type of problem we are going to consider, either structural problem or thermal problem or maybe electrodynamic problem or maybe fluid problem. What type of problem? That is problem statement. A clearly clarity must be defined to the system. That is problem statement. Now next, as per that problem statement, we are going to create a sketch. Whatever the problem statement, as per that input conditions, we are going to create a sketch. Sketch means that is with help of any software like CAD, or maybe any SolidWorks or CATIA, or maybe any different modeling software we are going to use, and with help of that we are going to create a model like a 2D sketch. After 2-dimensional sketch, we are going to convert as a 3-dimensional sketch in the software itself. We are going to create it. After that we are going to simulate it with help of CAE in the computer aided engineering. With help of computer aided engineering, we are going to solve that problem. This is actual methodology. Now after that, after analyzing, we are going to manufacturing. After finalize analyzing, we are going to manufacturing. Before that, any problem is there, once again revert back, like suppose any CAD model, after analyzing we got errors. In a modeling point of view, let's go to the modeling and verify it. Once again we are going to send to the CAE. Now after finalizing CAE, we are going to send to the manufacturing and testing. This is the general phase one step. If you are going to see the phase two, after manufacturing, now we got a product. After product, have nearly 100 component, 200 component you have fabricated or maybe manufactured. With help of software you fabricated. We are going to optimize in that component. We are going to optimize it. How to optimize? In optimization point of view also we have one tool in ANSYS or maybe other different softwares. We have that option, optimization. We can optimize the final optimization product. We are going to analyze it. That is, finally we are going to solve. If flow diagram, if you are going to see the flow diagram, the concept, what is the flow diagram? First one, flow diagram, design introduction. In the design introduction point of view, design introduction, we are going to solve the problem statement hand sketching. Similarly, CAD, CAM, CAE, computer aided designing, computer aided manufacturing, computer aided engineering, introduction point of view, CAD design we are going to use. Okay, next, FEM on solid mechanics overview. FEM or solid mechanics overview point of view, we are going to see FEM analysis, SolidWorks problem, whatever the problem, beam, truss, or maybe any type of problem, we are going to see with help of finite element analysis. Now, manufacturing training part, produce a part one, first one product we are going to test. After that, we are going to test it. Now any structural test is after testing of two or number of components, we are going to optimize the final product. We are going to verify it, the final product also we are going to test it, we are going to revise it. This is the general flow diagram any industry they are going to follow. If you are going to see the brief introduction for numerical method, what is the numerical method? Numerical method, whatever now present, we have the methods like a finite element method, or maybe finite difference method, finite volume method, or meshless method. These are all the numerical method only. Numerical method, another name is approximation method also. But theoretically, whatever now we have in strength of material or maybe solid mechanics or maybe heat transfer, we have problem. Theoretically, we solve the problem. Those problem values or maybe output or input values is the approximation values only. The output, whatever getting approximated, that's not an accurate value. But in numerical method, if you are using with help of numerical method also, we are going to get output approximation method only. But compared to theoretical, whatever the values we are going to get, compare the theoretical value to numerical value, but numerical value is a very good accurate approximation method. That's why we are nowadays everybody using numerical method only. These are all the numerical method: finite element method, finite difference method, finite volume method. Now let's start the definition. Define the finite element method. Finite element method is the numerical method. Now, finite element method, finite means some limitation of number. Maybe 1,000 or 1 lakh or 10 lakh or 1 crore of element. We are going to divide a number of elements. See, finite element method cuts a structure into a several elements. One component, one structure. Component means domain. In the domain, we are going to divide a number of elements. That is discretization, dividing the number of elements with a finite number of elements. That is pieces of structure, number of. Suppose if you are going to analyze a duster, if you are going to take a duster one component, one structure, in that we are going to pieces, number of pieces, with help of element we are going to divide. That is the finite element method. Then reconnect the element at nodes and nodes where pins and drop a glue that hold the element together. Now, whatever the elements you consider for dividing point of view, that element having compulsory nodes. No, in that node to node, we are going to there it's going to join properly or not. We are going to reconnect it. If it's not joined, we are going to reconnect it. This process is a set of simulation algebraic equation. Now, each element, whatever the equations we have. That equations, all equation, each not only element, each node equation, each direction of node equation, either the node is a linear direction or maybe non-linear direction, that linear equation, all linear equations we are going to convert as an algebraic equation. That algebraic equation, once again, we are going to convert as a matrix form. Finally, that matrix form we are going to solve. We are going to solve with unknown value, easily can find out. That is the finite element method procedure. If a fundamental concept, what is mean by number of degree of freedom? Degree of freedom, the most important in finite element method. Degree of freedom means mobility. Mobility means to arrest the motion. How many motions is possible to arrest in that position, in that plane? That is the degree of freedom. If a line, if you are going to take, how many possibilities are there? Line having only two nodes. Two nodes means 2 degree of freedom as per one dimensional problem. If a triangle is the two dimensional plane, that is plane, each node 2 degree of freedom, totally 2 into 3, 6 degree of freedom for triangular element. Like this, triangular element 6 degree of freedom possibilities is there. Now, this is the origin name and finite element method. We know the FEM means finite element method. Many engineering phenomena can be expressed by governing equation and boundary condition. Many engineering, like a engineering phenomena, like a structural engineering, thermal engineering, electrical engineering, fluid engineering, these are all governed by the equation. Suppose we have a heat transfer. Heat transfer, a governing equation is there. Fluid mechanics, a fluid mechanic governing equation. Governing moment of energy equation, mass energy equation, or maybe continuity equation, like a number of equation. These equations, mathematically we are going to represent, we are going to convert as a governing equation. Finally, we are going to apply a boundary condition. We are going to get a result. That is the method. If you are going to see each field variable point of view, how we are going to take a notation. For elastic generally a property is stiffness and behavior is displacement. That finally you will get F equal to K into U as per the strength of material. Elastic means strength of material problems. Like this, we are going to check. Take it out. If a thermal problem, that is non-structural problem, the property is conductivity. The similar to stiffness we consider. No, here we are going to consider the conductivity. Similarly, temperature, as a behavior u we consider known strength of material. Here we are going to take a temperature and heat source f as a heat source. Similarly, fluid problems, fluid dynamic problem, viscosity, velocity, body force, electrostatic, dielectric permeability and electrical potential and charge. Like this notation we are going to do. Finally, the equation is, finite element equation is f equal to k into u only. Next, what is a simple fundamental concept. Now, we know what is finite element method. Finite element method means some number of elements we are going to divide elements in that component. Now, it's very difficult to make algebraic equation for the entire domain. Suppose in this domain, see, this domain is very complicated. They divided a number of elements. See, this type of element, they divided a number of element. In this element having a number of nodes also. Each node we are going to take a equation. This node, first node, second node, third node, fourth node, fifth node, sixth node, seventh node, all equation, one single element having nearly 6 or 10 linear equations we are going to consider. Like this, number of elements, suppose take nearly 1000 elements are there, 1000 into 6, nearly 6000 equations we are going to consider in x direction, similarly y direction 6000, z direction also 6000. These are all equations solving very, very complicated in a theoretically. Very complicated. Another one is divide the domain into number of small simple element, the divided number of small into simple element. Field quantity is interpolated by the polynomial over the element. Whatever the equations we consider, equation either polynomial linear equation, maybe non-linear equation, depends upon the geometry, we will get a polynomial equation. Adjacent elements share the DOF connectivity nodes. Adjacent, so this element to this element, this node to this node, the connectivity properly you arranged or not, you are going to reconnect. Suppose it is not arranged properly, you are going to reconnect it. That possibility is there. That possibility is there. If you are going to see, after creating all element, we collecting all equation, that equations finally we are going to assemble all equation. Assemble means adding number of equations. Like a first node equation, second node equation, third node equation, first element and second element, third element. Finally, we are going to assemble like this. First element, second element, f equal to k into f equal to k into k. Right, like this, finally, we will get a final global forces equal to global stiffness matrix into total displacement. Finally, we are going to get like this, like this equation. Suppose you want to connect a displacement function. Displacement function, if you are taking displacement function u equal to f by k only, no, f by force by stiffness inverse, we are getting f is the matrix representation. Like this, we are going to calculate unknown displacement with the help of finite element equation f equal to k into u. Now the from uses the concept piecewise polynomial interpolation. Piecewise polynomial means each node polynomial equations we are going to consider with help of that all equations we are going to connectivity, that is adding of all equations, that is finite element uses piecewise polynomial interpolation. By connecting elements together, the field quantity becomes interpolated. What is field quality? Field quality is the unknown variable, that is unknown variable, like a stress, strain, temperature, displacement, these are all field quantity becomes interpolated. Now we are going to connect it to this all, we are going to assemble it over the entire structure in the piecewise fashion. After adding, we will get a one big piecewise fashion, like a big assembled structure. Assembled structure, a set of simulation algebraic equation at nodes, a set of equation, number of equation simultaneously we are going to collect it. Okay, see, k is the property, u is the behavior, f is the action. Depends upon the f only you will get a depends upon the property and behavior only you will get a force of action. See, the very simple here, one spring we added here, one simple overhanging spring is hanging downwards. Now we are applying a F is a force, automatic spring is elongate, that is depend upon the stiffness of that spring, it will elongate the x value, x is the displacement. Finally, this mathematical representation F equal to k into x you will get. depends upon the f, automatically it will change the k into x. Now advantage, if let's come the advantages of m. Advantages, main advantage, this is the only for main very important advantages. Can readily handle very complex geometry. You can handle very critical geometry like a IC engine. IC engine casing, if you are going to see the IC engine casing, IC engine having very irregular geometry. In that irregular geometry, how much forces is acting, what are the displacements involved in the inside of the component, you can analyze very easily with the help of finite element method. Well, theoretically very complicated, no? Like this, that type of geometry, very critical geometry. If you are taking a duster, duster is very simple, you can easily theoretically also can calculate, but a very complicated structure is not a possible theoretical calculation. That's why we are going to enter the finite element method. Finite element method easily it solve, but it will take time. Within maybe one day or two day it will take time, but theoretically it's very complicated. That's why it's very simple to calculate the complex geometry. Next is, can handle a wide variety of engineering problems. Variety, any type of application you can do the simulation, either solid mechanics, dynamics, dynamics in motion condition, any dynamic motion condition, heat transfer problem, heat transfer, fluid dynamic problem, electrostatic, these are all application. Any type of, at present nanotechnology also, at present nanotechnology, maybe fluid flow problems, now all medical application oriented, they are using this type of finite element method. Can handle a complex restraint. Complex restraint means the constraint, the boundary constraint, very complicated constraints also you can solve very easy. Complicated constraint means, suppose take a one beam having only two supports, that's all. It may be some condition in the beam itself, not only support, the temperature is going to act, fluid is passing on the component, like a two or three different boundary conditions we can apply and we can solve problem, easily can solve the problem. That is a complex strains. Can handle complex loading, like a different loads, like a nodal load, suppose element node, element having a three or four nodes, each node point of view are going to find out, like with the time varying how the temperature distribution, with the time varying how the brother load is distributing, like a frequency and a frequency dependent loading, like a own weight, with own weight what are the displacement, what are the forces involved in that component, like this type of problems also easily can handle with help of finite element method. If let's come the disadvantages. Disadvantages is the general closed form solution which would permit one to examine system response to change in various parameters is not produced. Here let me see that the main disadvantages are from is a closed form solution. Closed form solution means in the whatever before I discussed, one component, suppose take one duster having a load, some load is acting physically, another one is air is moving on the surface of the load, another maybe temperature also it's acting, temperature is acting. Every time to examine each variable, temperature point of view are going to examine, and a structural point of view, physical load point of view are going to examine, and fluid type of also are going to examine. This is very complicated to analyze this type of responses, this type of problems. Easily you are not going to, but you will get, but you are not going to produce. Next one is finite element method obtain only approximation solution. Already in starting itself I discussed finite element method also approximation method only. Whatever the theoretical strength of material we calculate in second year and third year, strength of material problem, that also theoretical only, that also approximation method only. Compared to the theoretical value, finite element value is the accurate approximation method only. Now the finite element method has inherent error. Finite element method, sometimes we are going to get a very complicated geometry point of view, so many errors. Why? Because so many equations, you know, suppose 1 lakh, 10 lakhs of elements you created in that component. Each element, a 3-dimensional element having a 10 nodes, so 10 into 10 lakhs, nearly 10 crores, 1 crore of element, 1 crore of nodes, 1 crore of nodes of equations we are going to solve it. Very complicated way, error scientifying also very complicated system, but it will take time. That is the main disadvantages for finite element method. Okay, next one is
What is the procedure? If let's come, that is the finite element method. Let's come to finite element analysis. What is the procedure for finite element method? What is the difference between finite element method, finite element analysis? Theoretical calculation. Theoretically, we are going to solve it. That is the finite element method, like manually. Theoretical means manual. Manually, we are going to solve it, finite element method. With the help of code, like ANSYS is the one code, like Abacus is one code, like any SOLIDWORKS is one code. You can, with the help of any software, we are going to solve the problem. We are going to call as a finite element analysis. What is the main procedure? The main procedure, three steps. One is the pre-processor, next one is the process, next one is the post-processor. Pre-processor means only for build a finite element model. Finite element one, input condition, simple, nothing is there. Pre-process is the input condition. Input means first one is geometry creation, one input. Another one is what type of element you are going to select, another input. Another input is what type of loads you are going to apply. These are all the, what is the material you can apply. These are all thing is the pre-processor. That is finite element model, to build a finite element model. If let's come the process. Process is conduct a numerical analysis. Now after giving the input of all things, it will solve automatically. It will convert as algebraic equation. That algebraic equation is the matrix. The matrix form where it's going to convert. Finally, it's going to equate the F equal to K into U form. Finally, F equal to K into U form. Whatever the unknown values, we are going, it's going to solve very easily. After solving, we are going to get a result. That result is the post processing. Graphically, we are going to visualize. That is method of finite element analysis. It's clearly given. Select the analysis type. What type of analysis? This type of analysis. Structural model, transient buckling analysis, contact. Select element time. These are all the pre-processor. Select element analysis, either two-dimensional analysis point of view linear, either truss, beam, three-dimensional analysis point of view a solid. Two-dimensional means shell plate, one-dimensional is truss beam. Be careful. That in that element is linear elements or quadratic element. Depends upon that, you are going to select a element type. Material property. Material property point of view, we are going to give the input either Young's modulus value point of view, the structural problem, Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio, now density, now alpha, thermal expansion, temperature point of view, thermal expansion must give, like a different material property must be due to the input of the system. Now make the notes like this, arranging the notes in that component and build after adding a notes, we are going to connect this with help of line element or linear element. Now apply the boundary condition. See, this node is fixed. This node is fixed, but in this node they are applying a load. These are all the load and constraints. Now process. Similarly, post-processing. In post-processing, what is the displacement, stress, strain? What is the temperature? We are going to solve. Thank you.